The eel breaks cover and edges closer. The snowflake eel jaw is armed with sharp, piercing teeth that curve backwards towards its throat to prevent prey from breaking free. When the eel has its prey secured, it unleashes the death blow that inspired Ridley Scott's Alien. A second set of jaws, located behind the eel's skull, lunge forward at high velocity. These pharyngeal jaws clutch the prey and pull it down into the throat for swallowing whole. Once caught in the double jaw grip, the crab can struggle all it wants. Escape is not an option. It will spend its dying minutes deep in the eel's throat.
Hello everybody, I'm Draco. It's been 2 months since my last video and I apologize for that. No, actually, I've taken a month's leave from my day job to focus on making the new multiplayer Stabfish game. I will call it Stabfish 2 for now. It took longer than I thought, but I successfully developed a secret feature for the new Stabfish game that probably you had never seen in other IO games before. In the new Stabfish, not only that you can equip a bunch of decoratives at the same time, but you can also customize their size and position and rotate them to any direction you want. With this tool, you can make sure you have the coolest and the most unique Stabfish in the game. Nope, this feature will only be available in the new Stabfish game. As you can see, I'm making new skins for all the existing fish and decoratives.
I just wanted to say thanks.
Well, you are not alone. IO Man, the admin of my Discord server, had put out a poll. Although it's 5 times more people prefer the new style, there are still few players like the old style better. But that's the reason I'm doing the reskin. The new skin is to help the game attract more new players. Furthermore, the new style is of a higher quality, so it has better chance to compete if I'm making it into a mobile app. And also, I've bought a new iPad to make the art, and this art style is helping me speed up my production. My task now is to reskin all the existing fish, weapons, and the decoratives in the classic version. Meanwhile, I'll release the new skins that are done onto the early access version of Stabfish 2, so you can keep track of my progress. I will leave a link below in the description. After that, I'm going to design a new skin family for classic Stabfish. I'm thinking a turtle family would be great. What do you think? The eel family was released last month, and as you saw at the beginning of the video, eels are fascinating creatures. Moray eels are like alien, oh my god, they have 2 jaws. Gulper eels look like a nightmare, but actually, they can inflate their pouch-like mouth and it somehow looks really cute and funny. The electric eel is not an eel despite the name, but rather a knife fish, which is more closely related to catfish. Aside from stunning their prey, they can also use the electric current to find them. To unlock the eel family in Stabfish.io isn't too hard, but will require a certain level of skill. To unlock Moray Eel, you need to achieve Stage 4 task 5 times, which means you have to achieve 6,000 points in 5 games while equipping the task as the weapon. The same goes for unlocking the Gulper Eel and the electric eel. You'll need to achieve stage 4 trident and stage 4 chill blade while using the Moray eel and the Galper eel. Once I add a new skin family for classic Stabfish, I will continue to develop the multiplayer Stabfish version. If you are interested to keep track of the progress, just visit the link and test out the early access version of the game. I will leave the link below in the description. And before I sign off, huge thanks to all of you who subscribe to my channel. My channel has made it to 1000 subscribers! Thank you very much, and I promise I have great plans ahead and you won't be disappointed. Stay tuned and happy stabbing!